a great beer at a great price.
We're back at the Forum for the second half of the USA-Canada women's basketball game, finishing off the round-robin play, a 10-point lead for the American team. But I must say this, if Canada were shooting up to its average, they were averaging about 45% from the field, then they would very well possibly be in the lead in this game. But as you saw from those stats, Canada's shooting was only 29% from the field.
And one reason also they've been able to stay in the game is because of the free throw line. They have 10 points at the free throw line. They've out-rebounded the U.S. They've really hit the offensive boards. I think the United States is going to have to concentrate on blocking out a little bit more. And another interesting note is the fact that Canada has 10 assists where the United States only has 3. And I think that's a big difference right there in the United States ball club, because they do pass so well and they're not getting the assists that they should.
Keep this in mind, too, that Ann Donovan, the starting center, and Cheryl Miller each have 3 personal fouls. With Donovan jumping against Sweeney, Miller gets the
lucky.
Tip.
Lucky. Miller got lucky. She could have gotten called for a foul there.
Could have gotten a foul right there. Exactly right. She shoved off a little bit in order to get to the ball. Lynette Woodard starts in the second half and puts it up and in. So the strong player from Wichita, Kansas, answers the bell to make it a 43-31 ball game. And Sylvia Sweeney on a drive, and a foul called on Sweeney for charging. Miller took the charge.
Great defensive move by Miller, took her position. Lawrence got beat baseline. Could have been called for a foul if she'd done any kind of bumping, but Miller was smart enough to take that charge and help out defensively.
Canada in a full court press there, and Janice Lawrence had a little bit of trouble getting it inbounds to Lee Henry, the point guard. And you post up Donovan inside. Ball goes to Lawrence. Whipped to Woodard. She drives and scores.
Talk about a quick first step. She just blew by the Canadian gal.
So Lynette Woodard comes out with the first 4 points of the second half for the U.S. women, and they jump out to a 45-31 lead. 14 points. That's the biggest to the ball game. Now Misty Thomas to Sylvia Sweeney. Debbie Hubin. Andrea Blackwell shoots from the top of the key and he won't go. Cheryl Miller gets the rebound over Misty Thomas. Bev Smith in the starting lineup for Canada. Inside Donovan against Sweeney. Won't go down. Miller taps it up and in. Cheryl Miller.
And she is all over the place. She definitely wants to play this second half. The Americans are really moving the ball well, outside and inside. Good play, pass for Donovan. She missed that shot, and Miller came out of nowhere for that tip.
Canada's ball side court now as Bev Smith plays it in to Misty Thomas. Sweeney is deep. Blackwell posts high. Hubin in the wing. They try to give and go inside, and Donovan scores it by slapping the ball out of bounds.
Americans playing really aggressive defense right now coming out in the second half. Canadians standing a little bit because the Americans have come out so intense.
This is Misty Thomas, and she gets the basket, shielding the ball with her body away from the defensive player, and Canada gets on the scoreboard here in the second half. 47-33, U.S. with 18:15 to go in the ball game. Miller looks for Donovan. Lawrence comes along low and give it away to Henry. There it goes to Woodard, and Lynette misses inside, fights for the rebound, puts it back up. Donovan has it. She scores it.
It looked like Henry was trying to pass to Donovan, but Woodard outjumped everybody, got the ball on the baseline.
Blackwell quickly down court, gets it up in a hurry, won't go. Rebound, Cheryl Miller. Blackwell now is 0 for 5 from the floor. Good play by Bev Smith. Steals the ball on the pass intended for Donovan. And a whistle against Lynette Woodard blocking. Her second personal foul.
Smith made a good defensive play getting the ball. Woodard just stuck out her chest right there.
Side court inbounds play. Debbie Hubin handling now. Andrea Blackwell, top of the key. Canada flashing across, breaking, trying to cut through, but the U.S. defense is so aggressive right now. And Janice Lawrence has taken an elbow to the eye. She's down on the floor for just a moment. You got a timeout coming up here for her with a USA 49, Canada 33, 17 and a half minutes to go in the game.
you believe we started this business in a shed back of my house?
Well, that our first 6 months, we sold 2 chairs.
The good old days. Now folks come from all over for our handmade furniture because we offer them good workmanship at a fair price. Fellas at Meisterbrau understand that. Today, we could pay as much as we want for beer, but this tastes as good as Budweiser and doesn't set you back as much.
And after a long day of sawdust, you build up a pretty good thirst.
Meisterbrau. Tastes as good as Budweiser at a better price.
Twelve years ago, there was barely a patch of grass to play soccer on in his country. Today, his country has a championship soccer team playing in the 1984 Olympics. His country offers free education all the way through college and free hospitalization for all its citizens. It has no income tax and virtually no crime rate. His country is Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia. Our people are our most important natural resource.
Perhaps you've noticed there's a new kind of Sears store in town. A Sears that sells business systems. With names like AT&T, Compaq, IBM, and Apple. Sears support, service, and Sears prices. For example, you can save $500 on this IBM PC package or this Apple Macintosh package. Both backed by a name you've trusted for 98 years, Sears. The Sears for business.
There's more for your life at Sears.
This temple crew has a plan, and they begin by digging into those
two scoops
in every Kellogg's pack.
Two scoops.
Keep them coming back for
two scoops
of plump, juicy raisins
in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Hooked up and in command, they're working now, but they're thinking how they love
two scoops
and Golden Flakes of Bran.
Two scoops.
They're turning back again for
two scoops
of plump, juicy raisins
in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
Are shattered or when they come to
we're with you.
When distant faces leave you wanting to touch, to care.
The people of ABC News, uniquely qualified to bring you the world.
Baskets by Donovan and Noble have made it a 20-point USA lead over Canada with 16 minutes and 8 seconds to play in the ball game. The United States defensive pressure beginning to exact its toll.
Not only the defensive pressure, but every time Canada has taken a shot, the United States is now blocking out, and the Canadians are not able to get those offensive boards like they controlled in the first half. And because the United States is getting those defensive boards, they're running their game.
Now let's go to Frank Gifford in our control with our score here, 53-33.
Thank you, Keith. And of course, we'll be coming back to basketball throughout that game to give you further reports. But we have a lot of activity going on today, and there is a lot.